Today is a potentially confusing day, but mostly it's exciting. Why? Because this video is being sponsored by 23andMe. 23andMe is named 23andMe because there are 23 pairs of chromosomes in every cell of your body, and they contain all of the genetic information about you, like your eye color, your propensity to cry at commercials with puppies, and you can find out where your family's from and all these things. Why am I nervous? I'm nervous because, like, what if we find out I'm really a boy? What if 23andMe informs me that I can't lose weight after 40? Then I can stop trying. Let's look at the footage of what it looks like to prepare your DNA. That's right, it involves the most sexy thing you can imagine, spitting into a very tiny tube for about 3 minutes. Check it out. Welcome to you. I've been living in me for 42 years. Wonder what I'm gonna learn. Oh, that's okay. I can spit that much right into there, I guess. So I didn't realize that I needed to wait 30 minutes after drinking my Thai iced tea before I could take my spit sample, so I'm gonna play a little piano. Is it time yet? Now, here's the deal. I know you watch a lot of YouTube videos. You probably watch a lot of television too. Maybe you even watch reality television. On those shows, they sometimes say things that are not true. I'm gonna tell you something that's absolutely true. I have not even logged into 23andMe since I sent that sample in. I have not seen these results. I literally don't know what's gonna come up. I'm very nervous. If this even makes it to a video, that will be amazing because maybe we'll find out horrible things and I'll start crying and all of my makeup will run down my face and now we will say we can't make this video. I'm so nervous! I literally think it's gonna be like, it's gonna pop up and be like, you're screwed! I hope it doesn't tell me not to be vegan because that's gonna be a hard day. It's so weird. I'm 99.7% Ashkenazi Jewish.
Oh my God!
I'm the Jewiest person anyone knows. I mean, whatever it is the Jews were chosen for, I've got it. Mostly it's heart disease and anxiety. 0.2% British and Irish. Hello! I am 0.1% broadly European. I'm gonna say that the broadest part of me is my hips and I'm blaming Europe for that. There is a way based on your DNA from your mom that they can literally trace the migration patterns of where your family went and how many years ago they went there. So we start in East Africa 180,000 years ago. And then it looks like my line branched out, wow, to modern day Saudi Arabia, modern day Iran, and then up into the Caspian Sea. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. Oh, hey now, I have fewer Neanderthal variants than 82% of y'all. Neanderthals are ancient humans who interbred with modern humans, and then they became extinct 40,000 years ago. This is amazing. Some of your traits may be influenced by having Neanderthal variants. I'm a terribly messy eater and I hate washing my hands. I feel like those are Neanderthal variants. You have one Neanderthal variant associated with a reduced tendency to sneeze after eating dark chocolate. Put that on a dating profile. Whenever I eat dark chocolate with friends, they're all sneezing and I'm like, what? Why would you sneeze? Now I know why, because they don't have that variant. Get ready for it, folks. I have one Neanderthal variant associated with having less back hair. I am unlikely to flush after alcohol consumption. I know you were thinking like, unlikely to flush after peeing in the toilet. That's also true, but that's not something that comes up at 23andMe. Why waste water if you don't need to? But unlikely to have facial flushing. It's a blood vessel thing. That is something I am unlikely to do. This is a wellness section that also tells me I'm likely to consume less caffeine than other people. I never knew that, but I actually don't consume a lot of caffeine and don't like caffeine. I don't drink coffee. I rarely drink tea. Once in a while, I'll have a soda. I am not likely to be a deep sleeper. Well, gosh darn it, 23andMe, you know me pretty well. I'm sure it's because of my high anxiety genes, but we haven't gotten to that yet. Here's something that's disappointing. It's a good thing. Predisposed to weigh less than average. So why don't I, 23andMe? My genetic muscle composition is common in elite power athletes. Do you understand what's happening right now? I've missed my calling. Oh, lifestyle and training factors drive athletic performance, though. Guess I gotta step those up. Genetics isn't everything. I know 23andMe, clearly. Here's something I've also known my whole life. Likely to have more than average movement during sleep. I'm a person who has more than average movement all the time, and it is also true in sleep. And now, whoever's lucky enough to sleep next to me will just have to deal with it because the evidence is right here, folks. Can't help it. I bet what you're wondering right now is, if I ever got to go out with Mayim Bialik and I ate asparagus, would she be able to smell it in my pee? Well, folks, yes. The chances are very good, I'm not even kidding, the chances are very good that I can smell asparagus in your urine. Unlikely to have dimples. That's true, I don't. Not on these cheeks. What? That was a cellulite joke. I have slightly higher odds of disliking cilantro. Like, there are some people who say that cilantro tastes like soap to them. I happen to love cilantro, so slightly higher odds doesn't mean that it's gonna be that way. Yes, likely to have wet earwax. Likely blue or green eyes, true story. Likely ring finger longer. It's not long enough to put a ring on it. Little freckling. Hair texture, likely straight or wavy. I mean, there's not that many choices. I mean, it, you know, we call it a Ashkenazi Jufro. Less likely to have thick hair. Thanks, 23andMe. Already knew that. There's some extensions in here right now. One of my sons has a photic sneeze reflex. One of them doesn't. And I likely have no photic sneeze reflex. That means when you go out in the sun and you sneeze, that's my kids are right there. Fred, you didn't get it from me, got it from your dad. Miles, right here. No sneezing when it's sunny.
But you also sneeze when it's sunny.
I sneeze all the time, that's a different story. Prefer sweet over salty, not true 23andMe. I know that this is just a predisposition. No, definitely more salty versus sweet. Toe length ratio, I won't show you my toes. It says likely big toe longer, meaning than the other toes. That is true on one foot only. Likely no unibrow. Thank you, 23andMe. Cause knowing the way this body works, for all I know, at 43, I'm gonna get a unibrow. Now I can say, no, I won't. One of the things that Jewish people all over the world tend to reflect on as the Jewish holidays are now, is our connection to a larger Jewish identity and what that means for our significance in the world. And learning this information at a time of year when I'm focusing so much on my spiritual identity and my connection to the Jewish community, even if I wasn't 99.7% Ashkenazi Jewish, having concrete information and being able to see that there's a whole world of people out there that I'm connected to is really, really special. And also just knowing that there's a place where we can actually get this kind of information, like this is where science has led us to in 2018. We can have this kind of information that keeps updating the more people send in their DNA. It's unbelievable. And I'm just really glad that I did this. And I really want to thank 23andMe for encouraging me to take this leap and find out more about what I'm made of and who I am. Maybe it's time for you to learn more about your DNA. Head over to 23andme.com/Mayim and enter your information and send in your spit in a tube and you can get all of this amazing insight into who you are and how you connect with the rest of the world. Thank you, 23andMe, and thank you everybody for watching. Like this channel, subscribe, share this, and tell me your experiences, if you've done a DNA screen or not. What was it like for you? What did you learn? And most importantly, is anyone more Jewish than me? Let's find out.